Hello friends, this video on gravitation part 3 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exams. Please make sure that you have watched part 1 and 2 before going ahead with part 3. We'll study acceleration due to gravity of the earth. So till now we studied universal law of gravitation. So the next topic would be acceleration due to gravity of the earth. What is this? It is the acceleration experienced by a body during its free fall due to the gravitational force exerted by the earth. So till now we saw that there is a force which is exerted by any two bodies on this universe. So every object, when it falls freely under the action of no other force, it is attracted by the surface of the earth. So that force is nothing but the force of gravity. Now it says that the acceleration experienced by the body when it falls freely. For example, let us consider the example of the apple falling down the tree. Now when this apple is actually falling down from the tree, in this journey, there is no external force on this apple. There is only the force which is exerted by the surface of the earth. So during this motion, this apple is falling. It is falling with some velocity, therefore it must be having some acceleration. So this value of acceleration is nothing but the acceleration due to gravity, because this acceleration is caused due to the gravitational force exerted by the earth. So you understood what is acceleration due to gravity? It is the acceleration in an object due to the force exerted by the earth. It is generally denoted by small g. So don't get confused. Capital G is used to represent universal gravitational constant, and small g is used to represent acceleration due to gravity. So please be very clear with what is small g and what is capital G. I hope you understood it. Universal gravitational constant is nothing but a constant in the universal law of gravitation, whose value remains the same throughout the entire universe. Whereas small g is the acceleration due to gravity. It is the acceleration in any object during its free fall due to the gravitational force exerted by the earth. Now we will study acceleration due to gravity in more detail. The next thing which we will study is an expression for acceleration due to gravity. That means how do we get the value of, or how do we evaluate acceleration due to gravity? Now let us suppose this is the earth. So the earth is revolving. So this is the surface of the earth. This is the earth's surface. And this is the center of the earth, right? Now let us suppose I need to calculate the value of acceleration due to gravity. Now whatever objects we see around us, they are above the surface of the earth and they get attracted towards the surface of the earth. Now let us consider that we have a body, we have any body of mass m. Let us say I have any body of mass m. Now what would be the force of gravitation between mass m and earth? So the force of gravitation between this object of mass m and the earth will be F is equal to g m1 m2 by r square. Now here m1 is the mass of that body, m2 would be the mass of the earth, divided by r square, that is the distance of the object from the earth. So whenever we measure the distance from the earth, we measure the distance from the center of the earth. So let us suppose if the body is here, so we will measure the distance from here. In this case, for the time being, we are considering that this object is very near to the surface of the earth. So we say that the distance between that object and the center of the earth is nothing but the radius of the earth. Because here we are assuming that the object is placed somewhere very close to the surface of the earth. So this r will become re square. So g m1 m2 by r square, right? Now we already knew from our previous studies, or from our studies of Newton's laws, we knew from Newton's second law. Try to quickly recall Newton's second law. Newton's second law defined force. It said force is equal to mass into acceleration, right? This was the statement of Newton's second law. Now, if you compare this equation with Newton's second law, that is with this equation, what will you find? Compare this equation with this equation. You will see that force is equal to mass into GME divided by RE square. This is what you have basically in this equation number one, right? So what is this? Force is equal to mass into acceleration. That means this quantity is nothing but it represents acceleration. Now this quantity would be the acceleration due to the force of gravitation. Why? Because this F is nothing but the force of gravitation acting on the mass M. So therefore small g, that is acceleration due to gravity, is GME divided by RE square. So this is the expression for acceleration due to gravity. Therefore, whenever we know the values of GME and RE, we can calculate the value of acceleration due to gravity. So in this case, I gave you the example considering that an object is placed very near to the surface of the earth. In that case, how do we calculate the value of acceleration due to gravity? Now gradually we will try to find out an expression for acceleration due to gravity for an object which is above the surface of the earth. Similarly, for an object which is below the surface of the earth, we will see those cases one by one in detail. So here we learned that G is equal to capital G M E divided by R E square. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thank you once again.